Hello, and thank you for watching this important video to teach you to correctly give you or your child a breathing treatment with an inhaler and spacer. After you have viewed this information, the nurse or respiratory therapist will ask you a few questions and have you demonstrate your understanding and ability to do a treatment. This is a meter dose inhaler, or MDI. Medication from the MDI can only work if it is used correctly. The medicine in the canister is under pressure, and because of this, a spacer or holding chamber must always be used to administer the medication. If this spacer is not used, the medication may not get to the lungs and can't do its job. The spacer allows for the medication particles that have left the canister to be held in the chamber for 3 to 5 seconds. Let's talk a little bit about the MDI. The inhaler prescribed to your child may contain a bronchodilator, such as albuterol, which is a fast-acting reliever medication, or it may be a corticosteroid, such as Flovent, which is a controller medication. It is important to know which medication is in the inhaler before giving a treatment. Inhalers can also have different amounts of medication inside, so to make it simple to keep track of how much is left, a counter can be found on the back of the inhaler. Please pay close attention to the counter and refill through your pharmacy or physician, making sure you have at least a 3-day supply between refills. Before you use the inhaler for the first time or any time it has not been used for 2 weeks or more, it is necessary to prime the MDI. To do this, you simply shake the inhaler, then spray 2 to 4 times away from your face. These puffs do not count towards your medication dose, but you should see the counter on the back go down by the number of puffs used to prime the inhaler. Now, the inhaler is ready to use. Now, let's go over how to do a proper treatment. Grab the inhaler, remove the cap, and give it a good shake 3 to 5 times. Place the MDI into the holding chamber, making sure it's all the way in. Be sure to sit upright or stand. This is the best position for the medicine to get to all of the areas of the lungs. Breathe all of the air out of your lungs. Put the spacer in your mouth, between your teeth, and make a tight seal around the mouthpiece with your lips. Press down on the inhaler. The medicine will now be trapped in the holding chamber. Breathe in slowly and deeply through your mouth. Now you will need to hold your breath for 5 to 10 seconds to give the medicine time to get down into your lungs. If you are unable to hold your breath, you can breathe in and out through the mouthpiece slowly, 3 to 5 times. You have now completed one puff. Wait 1 minute and then repeat these steps until you have completed the prescribed amount of puffs. If you are taking an inhaled steroid, you will want to rinse your mouth after the treatment. Be sure not to swallow the water, but spit it out. It is important to keep your spacer clean. You will want to wash the spacer when new, and then at least once a month at any time after recovering from a cold or respiratory infection. The spacer may become a bit cloudy over time, that's okay, but it shouldn't become discolored. To clean your spacer, disassemble your spacer, wash all of the parts, and clean warm water with liquid dishwashing detergent. Allow the parts of the spacer to air dry. Drying with a cloth or paper towel can result in static building up on the inside of the spacer, which makes the medication stick to the sides. Please be sure to ask any questions you may have regarding these instructions. Soon, your respiratory therapist or nurse will be here to answer any questions and make sure you have a good understanding of this information and have you demonstrate a treatment.